Uniformity of content of tablets, powder for parenteral use, ophthalmic inserts, and suspension for injection. So the content uniformity of all these doses form as per the European Pharmacopoeia 6 and Indian Pharmacopoeia 10 is discussed over here. So how to carry out the content uniformity test? So first of all, you take sample of 10 tablets or 10 single dose units and carry out assay of each individual unit and determine the content of the active pharmaceutical ingredients. Suppose the tablet unit 1 having the assay value this one, unit 2 has a sum what over here, unit 3 has some assay value, and likewise you determine the assay value of the 10 individual units. Now 100% is our target value. Here it is 85% and here it is 115%, here that is 75%, and here it is 125%. Now let us consider the first case in which all the 10 units come over here, that is within the limit of the 85% to 115%. So in this case the test complies or passes the requirement of content uniformity test. Now let us consider the second case in which out of these 10 tablets, 8 tablets are within the limit of 85 to 115 and 1 unit is over, or 2 units are over here, that is the outside the limit of 115 but below the limit of 125. In such a case the tablet fails the test. Now let us consider the case in which 9 units are within the limit of 85 to 115 and 1 unit is above the 125. At that time the tablet fails the test. Now let us consider the third case. Now let us consider the next case. Suppose 9 tablets are within the limit of 85 to 115 and only 1 unit is over here, only 1, between 115 to 125%. At that time you take the sample of another 20 tablets more, carry out the assay, determine the content, and now after analyzing these 30 tablets, that is the 10 tablets earlier and 20 tablets after, now analyzing these 30 tablets, suppose it is our target of the 100%, that is the 115, it is the 125%, that is the 85%, this is the 75%. Now out of these 30 tablets, 30 tablets, suppose the 29 tablets are within the 85 to 115 and only 1 tablet as the earlier case, because that will be remain over here only because it is a part of the earlier 10 tablets. So this is will remain over here only. So if the 29 tablets are within this limit and 1 tablet is outside the limit of 115 but below the limit of 125, in such a case the tablet complies or pass the uniformity of content test. Suppose let us consider the another case in which suppose instead of the 29 tablets. Only 28 tablets are within the limit of 85 to 115, and one more tablets is below the limit of 85%, but within the limit of 75. So in such a case, two units are outside the limit of 85 to 115. So this is not acceptable, and in such a case, the tablet fails the test. Because as per the requirement of the uniformity of content, only one tablet can be between these two or these two, only one, and the rest of the 29 tablets should be over here only. In this case, two tablets are outside, so the tablets will fail the test. So this was about the requirement of the uniformity of content. So this is applicable for the tablets, then powder for parenteral use, then ophthalmic inserts, and suspension for injections.